at Thompson Chevrolet live for Coach's Corner here this week. Final game of the season just finished up this last week. Finished up starting in the playoffs here. First round game is versus East Union coming up here, and Rob's going to introduce a couple of his players here.
Yeah, we brought back Gabe Sanchez, our quarterback, and Kendrick Bond, DB, slot, running back, kind of a hybrid player for us, and then James Perez is our receiver.
And long snapper.
Extraordinary.
East Union coming into the game is averaging about 30 points a game. Real heavy on the run side. They're averaging over 300 yards a game right now. They share the load with three different guys. They have one guy that's about 100 yards a game, but the other two are fairly close, so it seems like they've spread it out pretty evenly. Passing the offense is very minimal, but kind of situational, it seems like.
Yeah, they can be kind of a similar situation on offense, like kind of what we have. We have guys that share the load. We don't have one set running back that can carry the load 20, 25 times a game. We have multiple, you know, sets of guys that can get in and get the job done. And we take what we get from a defense, and they kind of do the same thing. If they're successful running the ball, they're going to continue to run the ball. But they do have playmakers that can beat you in the air. You know, the quarterback is athletic and can move in the pocket, can break the pocket, can dictate things, you know, on the field. And so then formation-wise, they're going to be very similar as us as well, except for they're going to be running more shotgun stuff. They're more shotgun-based. So it's very similar offenses for the most part.
Okay. Should be a good challenge going into this week. They've actually played some very tough competition. A couple of their losses have been some quality teams that they've played. One similar opponent you guys had was Ceres. Both of you guys took care of business.
They had Ceres the first game of the year. We had Ceres kind of a little bit later. But their schedule is what was their league schedule was very tough. They have Manteca, Central Catholic, and Oakdale in their schedule. And those are three losses, and those are all three very high-quality opponents and losses there. So, they're a very formidable opponent. Coming in at 7-3, you don't just step on the field and win football games on paper. So, you know, they've gone out there and found ways to win, and so you have to respect that. And we're looking forward to the challenge on Thursday.
Anything you guys throughout the season have done to kind of help you prepare for this particular week here?
Well, we've had the luxury of being able to play a Thursday game in the past. We played Modesto on a Thursday game, and so we've dealt with the short week in terms of preparation, coming off a Downey loss and then coming back right back to a short week. So for us to turn this thing around isn't very new. It's kind of like a carbon copy that we've already done for the week and how it lays out. So that helps us out quite a bit. Especially when it's a do or die situation for a playoff game, you kind of don't want to have that situation where you have a short week and you're playing on a Thursday, but it's the way it is going. That's the way it is for probably about 98% of the section this year.
What do you think some of the keys to this week as far as for the game? And I know East Union travels well. They bring a good crowd. I mean, home field advantage has got to be huge.
Yeah, East Union travels extremely well. I think they're going to be bringing some Rooter buses, so their fan base is going to be there. Something that we really haven't seen at our field this year since probably the Downey game. And so it's going to be a good, intense environment, and it's a good situation to be at home, at the confines of Patterson Community Stadium, and being able to, come down the street to your locker room at report time instead of getting on a bus and driving down here and to somewhere where you're not familiar. I don't know the last time we've had East Union on our campus. For most any sport. So it's something that, that's a big advantage for us. It's not the only advantage, and it's also not the one that will make or break anything here. So we have a lot to do in terms of just being focused on what our job is on Thursday.
Okay. We'll have four VIP field passes being given out for the game. Also a gift package. There is some online purchasing on tickets.
Yeah, we do have the ability for all the section is doing this for all their playoff games. If you go to www.gofan.co, gofan.co. You can purchase your tickets online ahead of time and skip the ticket booth line basically. And they're going to be the same price. Actually, right, I believe that up until Wednesday, I think there's a 15% discount. And all you have to do is redeem your tickets at the ticket taker table at the gate and show them your phone, redeem your tickets when it checks green. And then disappears. That's your way into the game. And so, if you go that route, it's going to save a lot of time and should make things a lot easier to get in and out.
Yeah, and tickets are a little more expensive during the playoffs, so obviously the four VIP field passes are...
Yeah, they're going to come in, it's $10 to get in. We only have a certain amount of passes that are available. We don't have the family passes for boosters isn't available. All the ticket money goes directly back to the section. So the ticket prices are increased, and the number of passes that are allowed to get in are few. And so it's another way to get in there at a discounted rate.
Okay. Well, I'd like to have everybody follow us on Facebook and see if they can win a chance for some tickets as well as a gift package. And good luck this week.
Thank you.
Appreciate it.